And now I can check the contracts. I'm gonna grab. Oh, look at that. That's probably gonna take forever. I'm gonna just grab 42. 35 can fend for themselves. Where is 42? It's not even that far. I guess most of them wouldn't be that far anyway. It would just be the ones in the 50 over there that's in Wisconsin. That would be a drive. And I don't know if I'm going to have enough fertilizer, but I still have money that I can definitely do that for, or buy more for. And this is for Jimmy. I'm almost to my contract field. It's just up here on the left. It's a ginormous field. Which I knew it was going to be ginormous by the price I'm going to get for this. Okay, let's unfold. Get to 90 degrees. Let's back up a bit and then get to 90 degrees. We're close enough that BCA will get that. It was still set for the maneuver spreader width. See how much, if my, I think I was close to 8,100 liters, not quite there, but close to 8,100 liters. Let's see if that's going to be enough. It is a ginormous field, how, almost 100 acres. A little church over there, and I believe that's a cell point down there. I think it's a weird cell point because both, it has two places to sell, but they're named the same thing. As you can see by the little mini map there, it's all field. Kind of cool to see, I guess. But I know it zooms in because I'm doing something that precision farming is showing me, but it's still. More than 1,000 liters. Just to go across the field once. I also should have went with my other tractor. I actually kind of just forgot about my other tractor. So I could have been here sooner because the other tractor has a higher speed. But it's also, you know, the one I bought for fertilizing. I'm going to have to end there. Don't want to end up in a ditch. I should actually, yeah, let's go to the other end and just go across. Maybe across twice. Probably have to do that on the other side as well. Just looking to see what it says this is. This would have been. I can't wait till the year that Jimmy decides to plant one of the root crops in this. I will not help him. And this is sunflowers. I like the root crops. I don't know if I like it enough to do 100 acres of it, though. I mean, it's likely I won't help him harvest the sunflowers either. That seems pretty sensible. There are multiple entrances on this field. I would need much bigger kit really to do this, although they do have demo models, not mottos, at the shop. So that you can try out some of the John Deere equipment that they have. I would definitely use one of the harvesters if I was going to help someone with the size of the field. My little, what, 6 meter header would take pretty much all month to do this. I don't think that this is a field you would do with just one harvester anyway. Yeah, like 2,000 meters for 12%. Probably gonna have to go and buy fertilizer. But I'm gonna be getting a lot of the money back, or all of the money back, but a lot of money. I'll be able to get that disc harrow and then be sling some more poop on my other field. And cultivate in both of my fields so that they're ready to be planted. I'll probably do both fields and corn. And then, well, I'm gonna look at what the pigs need to eat. Because I think they want a grain. I have to look at the XML or the PDF or whatever for Maize Plus. I also have the thing where they have multiple babies. I forget the name of the mod. But that should make them actually profitable, unlike base game. And then hope if I can get the grain in this year, yeah, I think I'll just go down this edge. But that way I'll be set up so that that will be done, and I'll just have to worry about next year having all the other crops. So by the end, before winter of next year, I'll be able to have pigs. I'm thinking I'll probably try to get sheep this year. I'm way close to the edge of the field. But yeah, this summer I'll try to get sheep. Going to get the disc harrow. I'll be able to get that after this contract. I'll want a way of at least making hay, if not silage. If I have the stuff to make hay, I would pretty much have the stuff to make silage. Wouldn't cost that much more. That will be next month's project. Then, as long as I can make hay, then I'll work on putting a sheep pasture down on some of my grass area that I have. Depending on how well I do, which pretty much means how many contracts I do, because I don't have a huge money maker yet, then I'll be able to plan more, because I will want cows eventually too. They're like my favorites, but it'll be easier to get sheep, obviously. Okay, no. Okay, I think I'll go up that direction. Okay, I didn't think that that was on the line. I didn't realize it was that far off the line. So I think I'll just go. Well, that means I'm going to have to do that at some point. So I'm going to go up. Well, I didn't think it would, but I was hoping that I would be able to do it with 8,100 liters of fertilizer. But nope. Okay, so I think I want to go north, which is actually south, but up on the map. Definitely will be finishing this field in the dark. But I would have been even if I had enough. I still have 10% to go on a crazy big field. But that's okay. I'm getting crazy big payoff. Definitely be able to get my disc harrow and pay my at least the amount of the loan that I want. I am going to want a corn dryer before October, but there's plenty of time for that. I think I'll want to get my hay set up for April though. That way I can put down the sheep, they can graze, and I can get some hay for them for the winter. And maybe get some silage, grass silage going too. This is a very dodgy road. What does the sign say? Caution, minimum maintenance road. Enter at your own risk. There's actually a road right next to where I grew up. Like, it's on the property. It actually goes between my father's property and his brother's, my uncle's property. And, ooh, why am I getting such bad? But that is, well, probably worse than this, actually. But it's also a minimum maintenance road. It's not really it's a road, but it's not a road in the winter. They don't plow it or anything. It's a snowmobile trail in the winter. It's a great place for, it has a great view. You can see for miles. You can actually see a lake that takes like 40 minutes to drive to. I'm gonna have to change one of my settings on this. So maybe I won't want to take this drive all that often. I sort of like, I don't know. It just was blinking because of how much it's. Okay. Yeah, I'll go down that road on the way back. Very dodgy. But yeah, the road near my father's property is, it's very dodgy, especially if you're going in a car. Definitely done it. But you can hardly go far at all. We actually would go camping on the land. We had a, my dad's parents had a 300-acre farm, dairy farm. And then that was split between my dad and his brother. So they each had about 150 acres. And there is a bullhead pond, which, if you don't know what bullhead are, they're basically tiny catfish. And we would go camping and fishing up there. I mean, it's not that far. You could definitely walk to it. It's still on the land, but we usually would take a tractor up there, actually. Well, my older brother would go with his four-wheeler, especially during hunting season. Well, I'm back with another 8,000 liters of fertilizer, which I definitely won't need all of. Just need to get 10% more on this field fertilized, and then I can go home and go shopping in the morning. There we go. I have finished the fertilizing contract. and can get my money and then head home. Not too bad. Just after 8. I think that the exit's up here. Oh yeah, the exit's not on the main road. It would be up there. And that's okay, that's the direction of home anyway. Oh, did I miss the exit? I don't think so. Oh, it's right up here. Could have just followed my tracks. Okay, let's turn that in. And there we go. I will be able to buy the disc harrow in the morning. But right now I'm just gonna go home, spray this down, put it away, and then eat some dinner, go to bed, and I'll see you all in the morning.